So here's an interesting numbers problem that I was asked about recently. Say that you have a rental property or perhaps manage a small hotel or something, and you've got a spreadsheet that looks something like this. You've got a rental rates and they change for different seasons. So for instance here at the beginning of the year, $129 a night, going up to $250 a night for the middle of the summer. And you've got these different rate areas throughout the calendar year and the amounts. Then you've got your calendar where you're going to fill in with what the rate is each individual night, and then you can add in who is reserved for that night. Kind of have something nice here that you can print or look at or something like that. Now the great thing would be to have these numbers from here automatically populate the calendar below, so that if you changed the rate, say for early spring, you wouldn't have to change all the dates here in the calendar. It would just happen automatically. Well, you can do this with a lookup function. The lookup function allows you to look up something in a table like this. So for instance, you can look up the word winter and then get the value 129. Look up early spring and get 152. But lookup also lets you do ranges, but not like you think, because here's a range and it would be great to be able to look up, say, February 28th and find that it fits in this range. But this isn't a range here. This is a piece of text. It doesn't even know that these are real dates. So how do you do ranges with the lookup function? Well, you can do them using just one date, and that would be like the starting date for the range. So I've actually created another column here and I've hidden it. So you can pretend I just created it now. Unhide all columns. I've created this column here with a start date for each range. And these are actually dates here. And you can tell when I click here, if I look at the bottom left, it says this is text. If I click here, it says this is an actual date and it's got a full time there. So this date range starts December 31st, 2016. This range starts March 18th, 2017. What happens when you try to do a lookup on a date is it, say if you're doing February 28th, it'll find that this is the one it matches, and only if it's March 18th or after will it match this one. So using the dates down here, I can then look up in this table and get the correct number. So the way I want to do that is use two different functions. One's the date function and the other is the lookup function. So let's see how the date function works. So here on the left I have a month, and that's an actual date there. So when I have just January, I just type January, and automatically converted that to January 1st, 2017. So it actually has a month, day, and year. And this is February 1st, 2017. So I have the month, day, and year, but the day is actually going to be from here, which is just a number. So I want to take the month and the year from here and the day from here. So the way I can do that is let's put a formula here. I'll put equals and I'll say date, and date takes the year first. So I'm going to get year from the year function, year of this date right there, then comma, then I'm going to get the month from the same cell, comma, but I'm going to get the day from this cell there. So it should give me January 2017 on the 7th. And sure enough, that's what I get here. It gives me, you can see 1/7, and then it would be 17 right there. So that's great. Now if I want that to be able to copy and paste everywhere, I need to do some work on that formula. So here, instead of having this cell reference move, I want to make sure it preserves the column so it always stays in column A. Same for this one, for the month. It's got to stay in column A. But this one, I don't need to preserve anything. I want it to move the column so it's always directly above the actual cell. So if I copy and paste it here, then I get January 8th. If I copy and paste all across, then I get the proper date there. So that's great. That's a great way to start, but I don't want just the date there. I want it to look up the rate. So let's go back to just this one cell here. So I'm going to go and modify this formula, and I'm going to feed this date into a lookup. And let's see what lookup looks like. If I search over here for formulas, you can see lookup will actually do this three parameters: search for, search where, and the result values. So search for is indeed the date. That's great. So that's my first parameter. Comma. Second parameter is going to be this column here. Search for it in the start date. And third parameter is going to be in the rate. Right there. That's the result. And put a parenthesis. Now I want to also make sure I preserve the column for that and preserve the column for that, because it's not going to change columns. It's not going to shift over one to the right if I copy and paste one cell to the right. I want it to stay these two columns. Now I hit return. I get 129. Great. Let's copy that and paste it across January. And you can see it's all 129s, which makes sense. I'm going to paste that in February as well. So I'm moving down these number of cells. So it should, instead of looking for January, say 3rd, it'll look February 3rd for that cell. I paste it in here. I get 129. Let me go and paste it all the way across for those 28 days. And you can see it's still 129, which is correct because this rate goes all the way to March 18th. Now let's go to March here and paste it in all 31 days in March. And now I can see it's 129 up until the 17th. The 18th, it's 152, which is exactly what it should be. And I could continue to paste it down here. Let's paste it all the way across for these dates for the entire calendar, etc. So you can continue down throughout the calendar. Now, let's say if I want to change the rate, maybe 152 is wrong. I want to change it to 149, and you can see all of those changed to 149. It didn't stick with the right format here, so let's change that to currency, and you can see it puts it all in there. So all I had to do was actually change the number here, and it automatically changed it in my calendar. As 2017 goes into 2018, I can continue to add more to this table here. So I can go from December 30th to, you know, March something 2018. I can extend the calendar down here. I can maybe perhaps even at some point save this out as 2017's rental rates and then do 2018 rental rates and change all these dates to 2018 dates, change these to 2018. If I want to. But the bottom line is that now I have something where the rate can actually be reflected from this table to this table.